And welcome back to the channel. In today's video, I will show you how can you make your own 5-band graphic equalizer based on an old IC which was designed to be used in a portable stereo tape recorder and a radio cassette. The circuit which you will be making is very simple and very beginner friendly too, so I recommend to give it a try. Now let's start with the building process, starting of course with the schematic which is now in front of you. Stay tuned for a demonstration of the circuit in operation at the end of the video. The circuit which you will be making will be based on LA3600, which according to the datasheet it is a 5-band graphic equalizer, which can be extended up to 10-band. What is a band equalizer, you might ask? The equalizer is a hardware filter indeed to adjust the volume of specific frequency of audio signal. The adjustment works based on the audio input by either boosting or cutting off certain frequency. And if we have a look at the block diagram of LA3600, we can see the basic of its operation. We can see it's made up from not so many components. C1 to C10 will be used to fix the resonance frequency of our audio signal. The value of condensator can vary slightly. With this formula, you can calculate the filter frequency. How to calculate, you may ask? As in this example, we know the IC has two internal resistors, R1 which is 1.2K and R2 which is 68K. Now the only thing remains to be added to our formula, it is the C1 and C10, which I like to say can vary slightly for increasing or decreasing the cutoff frequency. For adjusting the output of each band, a potentiometer is being used to be able to adjust each band independently. Let's start with the building process by grabbing all the required components for this circuit. I will be mounting everything on a prototype board, which is often called Vero board. Let's add first the LA3600 IC on a Vero board and solder it. I recommend you to use a socket, but in my case I didn't have a 16-pin socket, but 2 8-pin socket work pretty well, I may say. The next step will be to add the rest of the components and soldering them to the Vero board. After some time, the circuit is ready. We can test the circuit by providing 12 volts or even 15 because the IC can stand up to 20 volts. After, we can give power to the board along with our audio signal, which will be provided by using my audio function generator. And let's connect the output of LA3600 to our oscilloscope, and by rotating the potentiometer we can see how the sine wave is getting distorted or slightly offset. As you can see, the circuit is working great, and with some extent the circuit can be modified to work with 2 LA3600 for 10 band graphic equalizer, but this is a subject for another video. Here is a live demonstration of the circuit operation. So we get to the end of the video. If you have any idea for an upcoming video, leave your comment down below. And I hope I will see you all in my next video. Until then, have a nice day and thank you very much for watching. See ya!